In this video, I will be discussing the architectural components of SAP CPI. I will explain what are different components, explore various personas involved, and examine their interactions. Let's get started. SAP offers three different types of microservices called design, monitoring, and operation microservices to work with SAP CPI. The design microservice provides a graphical interface for designing integration flows. Monitoring microservice helps in monitoring the integration flows and provides real-time insights into the performance of integration flows. Operation microservices provides tools for managing and operating the integration flows. It allows users to deploy, update, and roll back integration flows, and it provides tools for backup and recovery. Both the design and monitoring data is persisted locally in CPI. In SAP CPI, workers refers to the runtime instances that execute the integration flows. They are responsible for processing the messages and the data that flow through the integration flows. The number of workers in SAP CPI can be increased or decreased based on the load requirements. Each worker runs on a separate virtual machine, providing scalability and reliability to the integration flows. Workers in SAP CPI are JVM, Java Virtual Machine instances. We have message content and runtime data which will be used by workers for integration flow execution. In SAP CPI, a load balancer is a component that distributes incoming traffic across multiple worker instances. The load balancer ensures that the message traffic is evenly distributed among the available worker instances, providing high availability and scalability to the integration flows. Now let's discuss the various personas involved in SAP CPI. The integration developer is responsible for designing, deploying, and executing integration flows using the web user interface. The admin is in charge of managing administration tasks and user management within SAP CPI environment. The integration developer utilizes the web user interface to design, develop, and execute integration flows. They initially create an integration flow using microservice, and the integration flow data is stored in design data and monitoring data persistence. Once the integration flow is deployed, the worker processes read the data and execute the integration flows accordingly. After the integration flow is deployed, a sender can transmit a message to a receiver, and the worker process takes over the entire message handling process. The message content and runtime data are persisted in the respective areas. In SAP CPI, customer data is protected using tenants. The monitoring data, message content, runtime data, and worker processes are all part of a specific customer's tenant. This ensures their data is secure within a given tenant. On the other hand, the design, monitoring, and operation microservices are shared across multiple tenants, providing a common platform for integration management. This approach ensures the customer data is isolated and secure within their own tenant, while still providing a scalable and efficient integration platform through shared microservices across multiple tenants. SAP CPI comprises fundamental components that work together seamlessly to create reliable and effective integrations between sender and receiver systems. Additionally, SAP CPI stores certain integration flow data locally for specific purposes. If you like the video, consider giving a like or subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.